Hi, I'm Alex Pault, editor-at-large with Electronic Design, and I'm here at the PCIM show with my good friend and friend of the show, Jin Witham. How you doing, Jim?
I'm doing great, Alex.
Well, especially considering the things have been going on between you and Infineon, can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, sure. I mean, big news. We announced in March that we'd come to an agreement between Infineon and Gan Systems to merge. We're now in that period of time where the regulatory authorities, the U.S. and Germany and Canada, are all investigating and looking at the deal. And we expect the deal to close by the end of the year. And at that time, the two companies will come together. What I'm excited about is when that happens, we'll be having a GAN business line that's focused entirely on the growth of GAN. So the Infineon GAN team, the GAN Systems GAN team will come together and continue to write the next chapters in the GAN book.
Very cool, Jim. Now, you've got some nice demos at the show here. Why don't you walk us through a couple of them, okay? Can you tell us what you're going
to
show us?
Yeah, I'd love to show you some things. I think first I'll start off with a little history lesson of what customers were using GAN for 3 or 4 years ago, what they're doing today, and then I'll move over into the audio and the automotive marketplaces, which are two fast-growing marketplaces for GAN.
Very cool. Well, then let's take a look.
This is an interesting history lesson on how the data center customers have used GAN devices. These power supplies here go in a data center power rack with servers. This is the silicon version. This is the GAN version. You can see 50% more power in this box and 2% more efficiency gain. That saves data center money in terms of electricity costs. They can also get more revenue by putting more servers into the rack. Now, this is a 2-year-old power supply. This is this year's power supply. You can see another 50% improvement in power density. What I find interesting here, and what the history lesson is that these devices, GAN devices, and these GAN devices are exactly the same. The way they're able to get more efficiency out of GAN, more power density out of GAN, is by topology, by choosing the right ICs, and by heat transfer. And so this is kind of getting the raw power out of GAN, and this is getting all the performance out of the GAN. So this plays out in many of the other industries also, but this is a great graphical example of what GAN can do to a business, this one, the data center business. This is another one of the fast-growing marketplaces for GAN devices, and it's the audio market. GAN is great for audio for small size, good efficiency, low cost, just like all the other marketplaces. But in audio, there's one added feature and benefit, which is the fast switching speed of GAN more faithfully reproduces the audio sound. Sound is great on GAN. These are audio reference design boards, both the power supplies and the audio amplifiers, used in a wide variety of different applications so that our customers can pick and choose it fits what they want to do with GAN and their audio amplification applications. Where this is playing out in the marketplace, one of the examples is powered speakers. This is a speaker here where the power supply and the audio amplifier are embedded in the speaker. And you can only do that with a high efficiency, no heat sink GAN design. And to get the best sound, GAN amplification. This is another example where Daniel Hertz is doing powered speakers using a very similar approach and started with the reference designs that I show here. This is the automotive portion of our booth. Here are the big three in terms of automotive electronics: traction inverter, onboard charger, and DC-to-DC converter. And you can see examples of where our customers have used GAN devices to make really lightweight, small, and efficient powertrain electronics. This is the power inverter from the all-GAN car done by Toyota. It's a prototype car running around Nagoya and Tokyo to get miles on GAN devices and experience in the traction inverter environment. This here is from Canoo. They make the Walmart delivery vans. This is the first production GAN onboard charger in the marketplace, and it uses GAN Systems devices. This over here is a very interesting DC to DC converter from Vitesco. Why is it so interesting? This is one design, one SKU, one product, which can do both 400 volt and 800 volt battery systems. You just do different connections for a 400 volt system than you do for an 800 volt system, and it works in both. That allows Vitesco to be able to serve a wide variety of the marketplace. 400 volt cars tend to be smaller cars, city cars. 800-volt battery systems tend to be big muscle cars and high-speed cars. One design fits all.
This is kind of the hit of the show, at least for automotive engineers. This is an 11-kilowatt, 800-volt onboard charger. Why is this special? There's kind of been some talk in the industry about 800-volt battery systems being SiC and 1200-volt. And saying that GaN and 650-volt devices just, you know, won't make it happen. But what we have here is a three-level architecture that uses those 650-volt GaN devices, and it beats the performance of 1200-volt silicon carbide. We've made a reference design here that is 36% better power density and 15% lower bill of materials cost than a SiC two-level converter. So we're throwing the gauntlet back to silicon carbide to say, okay, beat this.